My name's Alan Fleming, I'm the Central North Island Field Officer for Forest and Bird.
My name's Hamish Dean and I work for Forest and Bird. I'm the Kaimai Connection Coordinator.
Yes, well my name is David Dowrick and I'm Chairman of the Tauranga branch of the Forest and Bird Society.
Kia ora, my name is Tommy Kapai Wilson. I am a children's author and within the Kaimai catchment range, my role is to look at the opportunities for education to teach our children about what is in their own backyard, in this case, the Kaimai ranges.
Forest and Birds, New Zealand's oldest and largest conservation organisation. We have over 70,000 members and supporters, which includes 20,000 children who are members of our Children's Conservation Club, KCC. We're a grassroots organisation where branches get out in the weekends and undertake pest control and revegetation projects, restoring our natural heritage. Kaimai Connection is a large landscape scale conservation program linking the Bay of Plenty with the Waikato. It includes the Aongatete and Te Puna catchments in the Bay of Plenty, over the Kaimai Ramaku ranges to the Middle Waiho catchment in the Waikato. It's named the Kaimai Connection because it connects the two areas and a range of habitats.
So here at Aongatete, and in a lot of the Kaimai range, the bird populations have been depleted a lot. Most of the birds, the common forest birds are still present, but in really low numbers. But things like kōkako, kiwi, falcon, kākāriki, things like that have mostly disappeared. There may be a few kiwi left around the place, but there's not many. And this project, the Aongatete Forest Restoration Project, is all about returning those birds to this part of the forest.
Some of the birds that we get in the forest here are shown on this. Most of these are still reasonably common, except for the tomtits, which are only little wee birds, and the robins, which are quite susceptible to high levels of rats. But these are now, since the control's been underway, these are coming back now. There's more of them. The trust's been monitoring them every year, and there's more and more. So that's a good sign for the pest control. Over here is the main nasties in the bush, the pests. So possums eat vegetation and they eat chicks, bird chicks and eggs. They eat anything they can get their hands on. And rats, which are mostly ship rats, they eat everything as well. Seeds of plants, flowers, they'll eat chicks, they'll eat eggs, and they're great climbers, so they're really good at getting into birds' nests. So really, rats are the biggest enemy in what's being concentrated on at the moment.
The Aongatete Forest Restoration Project started back in 2006, and it was started by the Tauranga branch of the Forest and Bird and the Katikati Rotary Club. And they recognised that the forest here had been pretty badly damaged over the years with logging and then with introduced pests. So they started back in 2006 doing possum and rat control, and now stoat control is done as well. And they are now covering about 250 hectares, and that's been regularly controlled for rats and possums. And then just recently Forest and Bird have started working to expand that 250 hectares, and our aim is to get out to 1,000 hectares in a few years' time. as resources allow.
To monitor the number of rats that are, well, to monitor how effective the rat control has been, we, like everyone else, use tracking tunnels, and these are just these plastic tunnels that are set in lines that go through the bush, and they're just left out in the bush all the time. And when we want to know what how effective the control's been and what the rat numbers are doing, we go out and put these tracking cards into the tunnels, so they slide in here like this, and they've got an ink bit in the middle here, and we put a dob of peanut butter in there, crunchy peanut butter, and leave it out overnight. And this is one that was out last week, so the rats come in and to get the peanut butter, and they get ink on their paws, and they mark their paws, they leave their paw prints on the ink card. So this one here has obviously had rats on it, at least one rat on it, and you can see on here as well that there's been a possum has managed to get its paws in there as well. So that's how we get a relative number, an index of rat numbers for the bush. This is one of the stoat traps that spread right around the restoration area, and it's a Doc 200, it's called, and it's set with an egg, a fresh egg, just a standard old chook's egg, and what's remaining of a piece of dried rabbit as well, because stoats really like rabbit meat and eggs. So the idea is that the stoat comes in through this little hole here, which is too small for a cat or anything else that might ruin it, or a possum. So it's got to come in through there, and then comes in through there and stands on the treadle on his way to get the thing. Oops. And gets instantly killed because this, which is powered by a very strong spring, just crushes its head, and it's dead instantly. So it's a pretty humane way of killing stoats, really.
The pest control program is based on transects through the bush and bait stations where we put poison, and the possums and rats come and get hold of it and go away and die. And volunteers put in the bait station lines, we call them, so which are just tracks through the bush. Mostly they're straight, and they're set. Our ones on the north side here are set 100 metres apart, the tracks, and every 50 metres along there we have a foolproof bait station. In the truss block, I think they are 75 metres by 50 metres or something like that, so they're a bit more closely spaced.
The main, the backbone of our restoration in here is killing rats and possums, and these are the bait stations that we use. Put poison into these. So they just get lifted up, and the poison gets put inside there. Rats and possums can just come up here and get their fill of poison, and they normally go away and die. Possums in this area, we've just recently had cyanide out for them, so there's a good kill of possums.
We mark all of our tracks through the bush with, in our case, they're pink markers, pink triangles, and tape. And then also in there, there's a stoat line, several stoat lines, which wander all through the project area, with stoat traps, I think, about every 200 metres along there. And we also have rat monitoring lines through the bush, so you end up with quite a lot of different tracks through the bush. They're all marked with different colours, though, so we know roughly what we're doing and where we're going. Fire is from the trees. Well, the truth of the matter is it's too hard to see. Virus from the trees.